Hey, everybody, what's happening? It is another Sunday, another Spelt Sunday for you. So I'm a little bit closer today, so it's a little bit windy. So I want to make sure that I project and that you can hear me correctly. So by popular demand, we're having a core-focused Spelt Sunday. So I'm going to go through same thing as usual. We're going to do a warm-up. We're going to be doing a set of exercises, 30 seconds on, 30 seconds active recovery, and then we're going to be getting into a triple threat. And when I say triple threat, I mean that it's just three exercises back to back with no rest. So first thing we're going to start with is good mornings. So anything that I do, I'm going to try to show a modification. In terms of a lot of this core stuff, if you're having trouble doing planks or anything like that, you can kind of see there's a raised surface here. You can do everything on a raised surface. So you can do a plank on a raised surface. You can do mountain climbers on a raised surface. That will help a lot with your, if you have hand pain, if you have back pain, you just can't get up and down off the floor. That's going to help a lot in terms of modifications for you, okay? So here we go. First thing you're starting with is good mornings. Doing eight good mornings. So down, one, two, three, really push your hips out, four, five, big breath, six, seven, and last one, eight, good, shake it out, we're going squat reach now, so squatting down, okay, feet wider than shoulder width, and then reaching up, pushing off this toe. If squatting is too much, too deep, just do a half squat. Same thing, okay? So if you see a squat, can't do it, do a half squat. See a lunge, you can't do a full lunge, do a half lunge, okay? Four more, four, three, two, and one, last one. Now we're going open palm twist. So just twisting, getting your back and your core nice and warmed up, pulling that rib cage in, keeping those shoulders down and back. Three, two, one. Now we're going knee to chest. So standing knee to chest, nice and solid, and pull. Even a little bit more as you pull, you're going to come up onto your toe. This is three, four, five, getting six, going to eight here, seven, last one, eight. Good. Shake it out. Now we're going hip open. So just sliding open. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, big round, eight. Good, shake it out. Last thing your warm up is called a table crunch, okay? So, just going in an all fours, okay? Right arm, or right leg out, left arm out, and you just do a five each side. One, two, three, four, five, and if this is too much pressure for one of your knees, all you have to do is come here and you go lift the arm, hand down, lift the leg. Okay? Lift the arm, hand down, lift the leg. So that's your modification. Do three more here. Two and one. All right, so warmed up here. Core is warmed up. So this is a full core workout. Now, some of these exercises you're going to go, wait, this isn't all about my core. A lot of it is. You have to make sure that when we're doing any exercise, everything is nice and tight, pulled in. Your hips are rolled under your pelvis. Nice athletic stance. Shoulders down, chest up. Okay? Don't splay here. Chest up, pull that rib cage in. So, let's go through the exercises and then let's get right to it. So, first thing we're doing is a sumo hop squat. Okay? So, this is one of the ones you're saying, really? Core exercise? Definitely. Okay? So, you jump in and then out. So as you do that, your chest stays up, and as you come down, you're gonna feel a lot of tightness in those lower abs, which are really hard to target. So make sure that when you're coming in and out, that you're really keeping a nice tight core. If jumping is just not working for you, I want you to sit down, stand, reach. Down, stand, reach, okay? That's gonna give you that same core activation. Next thing we're doing is twisting knees. So now, this one can get confusing for people, so you've got two options. You can either follow me going one, two, three, one, two, three, or if you just don't want to think about it, you just go opposite knee to the elbow. Okay, so you can do that as well. So again, you're either going one, two, up, one, two, up, one, two, up, or up, up. Okay, if you just don't want to think about things. Next we're going is triangle reaches. So feet wider than shoulder width, hand goes up in the air. Okay, on one side we're going to do 30 seconds on right going down, then we're doing active recovery, and then that next exercise is the other side. But foot facing up, maybe 45 degree angle, up and just reaching, arms straight up. You're going to feel a ton of pressure in those obliques. Really important that you pull your shoulders back and you reach. If you are getting pain, only go down as far as you can. Like, I'm very tight, so I can't really go down that far. But I'm still getting that great oblique work. Then we're going around the world. Okay, 15 seconds in each direction. So up, reach, 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 and over. Okay, up, reach, reach, reach. As I'm reaching, I'm pulling my ribcage together. Even the active recovery is ab work, okay? Then we're going triangles to the other side. Okay? Triangle reach the other side. Getting back down, back into that table crunch positioning. And you're going to be going on all fours, okay? Leg comes up and over in that bent position. Up and over. Up and over. You go 15 seconds each side. You're really going to feel your lower abs working here. As you come up, there we go back down. Plank hip tap. So, a couple options here. You can go on your hands, okay, reaching down to your hips or your knees, hips or knees. A little bit harder is on your forearms, same positioning. And then the third way is to do it on a raised surface. So countertop, bench, whatever you have. From here, okay, pushing up and reaching. Sink the hips down, push up and reach. Sink the hips down. Okay, so really great option. Obviously, this isn't the best for me because it's not even, but that's what you're going to be focusing on, pushing up and reaching. Last exercise as you're active recovery is just holding a hip press. So just holding straight up. If you want a little bit more, you can raise the leg, okay? But really focusing on pulling in your core, squeezing your butt, trying to reach your heels with your hands. Okay? Triple threat. Triple threat here. Pike hops, boat holds, and a cross leg pulse, okay? So, pike hops. From here, we're going jumping up and back, okay? If you can't do that, you're going to go ahead and do it on a raised surface, jumping up and back, up and back. If that's not working either, like you're just jumping is not in the equation for you, completely fine. I want you to be on a raised surface, okay, lifting the legs. You can also be on the floor lifting your legs as well if you want to do it that way. Boat holds. Okay. Holding 10 seconds just like this. And then the last one is the cross-legged pulse. So this one's a little bit different. So you're going to be sitting. As soon as we go from this, we're going to boat holds. You cross your legs and you push up and then you sit down. Up. Push up and down. So if this is hurting your wrist, try your knuckles, okay? So from here, up, here, up, and it doesn't seem like much, but you're really compressing a lot of your core, okay? So we're going 10 of each of those. Let's get into it now that I've warmed myself up talking to you. Let's do this. Okay. Let's do 10 jumping jacks. If you can't do jumping jacks, okay, you can step and do the arms, right? Stepping arms, or you can do full body extensions to wake yourself up a little bit here, okay? So if you're doing jumping jacks, you're starting with me. We're going to do 10 jumping jacks, and we're going right into the sumo hop squat. So I want to get you warmed up a little bit more, and then right into that sumo hop squat. Remember, that one is out and in. Out and in. If you can't do that, right, step, bam, reach. Okay, ready? 10 jumping jacks, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and sumo hop squat. Ready? 30 seconds. Down. Breathing. pulling in that core every time you sit. Remember, next we are going into the twisting knees. Make sure that, you know, if you're not feeling like you're getting that core activation, put your hands around your waist and flex. Sit down. Sit. 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 Last one. Bam. Okay, so if you're with me, 1, 2, 3, right? 1, 2, up. 1, 2. Why are you doing this? Remember? Just be solid, whatever you do. 1, 2, 3, because if you're not solid and you try to raise your knee, it's not good. You want to be solid. 3, 2, 1, triangle reach. Ready? 30 seconds here. Reaching. Reach. Pull your shoulders back. Flex the core. Coming up and down. Going right into around the world. 15 seconds each direction after this. 5 seconds, 4, reach 3, 2, 1, big breath around the world. Up and over, pulling the core. 15 seconds here, then I'll switch directions for you. Really reach. As you reach, good. Last one in this direction, switch directions now. Up and over. Good. Flex everything. Don't even let your core or your arms go limp here. Everything should be activated. And we'll go one more. Up and triangle reaches. Ready? And go. Reach. 30 seconds here. Reach. Good. Great amount of core work here. Going right into table. Right? Tabletop. Leg reaches. Good. 10 seconds. Good. 3, 2, 1, and down. Okay, 15 seconds each side. Ready? And tap up and over. Good. Try to keep your chest right over your hands. Start a little late, so let's go one more and switch legs. Up and over. Up and over. Good. Really flex everything. Widen up those fingers, lock the surface area. Go three more. 3, 2, 1, and into that plank, reaching up, right? Reach up. Reach. If you need to, come here and reach. Flex, reach. If not, come down, reach. Tuck in that shirt. Reach. Reach as far as you can. Push those hips up in the air. 10 seconds. Go right into a hip press hold so you can push yourself a little. This is definitely going to be active recovery. Let's go 1, 2 more, and on your back. Ready? Press and hold. Okay, hold, hold, hold. If you want a little more, okay, you can alternate. If not, just press up, hold that core nice and tight. 15 seconds. Feel your back, okay? Make sure it's flexed. Squeeze your butt together. Try to squeeze your knees together. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's get up right into your triple threat. Take a deep breath. Remember, we're going pike hops, boat holds, cross leg pulses, 10 of each. Ready? 3, 2, tuck in that shirt. 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can see me here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stand up, sit down. Ready, hold, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, hold, 3, 2, hold for a couple more seconds, good, now up, push, 1, 2, 3, can you go here, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, hold, and breathe. Woo. Awesome work. 5 minutes. That was your Svelte Sunday core. Now, just for a little bit extra, let's do one more 30-second exercise with one more 30-second active recovery, okay? So this is gonna be like a Spider-Man D. Three different ways. First way, okay, nice and wide, okay? Knees go to that off to that same elbow, nice and wide. You can do it here on your hands, same thing, or hardest on your forearms, up and out, okay? Then we're going into sitting Russian twists. First way, feet down. Second way, feet up, okay? So let's do this. I'm gonna give you about a 10-second break, then we're going into those last two. Now make this count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 30 seconds, up and out. If you need a push-up, do that, or alternate. Just get it done, okay? That's all I ask, just get it done. Start to feel things burn, get down, 10 seconds. Five, four, three, two, hold it, Russian twist, ready? And go. Right, you need to reach, sit, and reach. Not get those feet up. Whew. Come on, you got this. Your hip flexor's gonna burn a little. Let them burn, keep going. Whew. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, push with me, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold it, hold, 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 breathe, breathe, breathe. Stand up, shake it out, reach back, back bend. Oh, breathe here. Oh, that was awesome. 7 minutes, 7 minutes, that was it. Full core slam. Do this once, do it twice, do it 3 times, do it 4 times, do it 5 times. If you do it 5 times, take a video. Take a video of yourself doing it. It's going to be a longer video. But if you take 5 times to do this, okay, it's going to be about 35 minutes, right? Maybe a little bit less if you cut out the talking and whatnot. If you take a video and you send it to me or you post it on my wall, I'll send you some cash. How about that? I want to see that you're doing it. So I'm challenging you. I will send you, I'll PayPal you $300 cash if you do 5 or more rounds and you record it and you send it to me or post it on my wall. I will PayPal you $300 cash, done. Because I want to see that you're doing it, so I'm incentivizing you to really push it to the next level, okay? So that's my challenge for you. Hopefully I can send you some cash. Post your wins, post your losses. If you want to see more stuff like this, let me know. And you want to see more core or more back or more butt, whatever, just send it to me, okay? So that's all I got for you guys today. Have an amazing Sunday. Get your core work on. Do 5 or more rounds. I'm going to send you $300 cash, baby. All right. Have a great Sunday. Later.